ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವುದನ್ನು ಹೈಯರ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಮ್ಯಾಥಮೆಟಿಕಲ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಷನ್ ಇಲ್ಲ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಲಾಜಿಕ್ ಬೇಸ್ಡ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಏನ್ ಯೂನಿಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಈ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲೇ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಅನ್ನಿಟ್ರು ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯನ್ಸ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನಿಟ್ಯೂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಪೊಟೆನ್ಶಿಯಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಟೂ ಟರ್ಮಿನಲ್ಸ್ will be the same as the two voltmeters in parallel. The next question. Now the question is from optics. Quite interesting. A, B and C are three parallel sided transparent glass slabs. A, B and C are three parallel sided glass slabs with refractive index N1, N2 and N3. And here the refraction is happening in this manner, where very clearly it says refraction into the medium B, the ray grazes the separation between B and C. Here I am asked to find the value of sine theta. Andre, a ray of light travels from A to B, suffers refraction, travels from B to C, and very clearly he says here the ray of light is grazing the given surface. Grazes andre, it just passes over the given surface. Grazes the given surface. Now, I call this angle of incidence as I. In the first medium, the angle of incidence is I. And here, the angle of refraction I call as R1. The same refracted ray is falling on the next surface. So here the angle of incidence is R1 and here the angle of refraction is R2. Now from Snell's law we know N1 sin I or is equal to N2 sin R. We call this as the general law of refraction. For the first surface, refractive index is N1. Sine angle of incidence is I. Next surface N2 angle of refraction is sine R1 and I call this equation 1. Now for refraction between B and C. Now I will consider refraction between B and C. N2 sine. Now what is the angle of incidence there? R1 equals N3 sine R2. Now what is N2 sine R1 equal to? So this is N1. Sin I equals N3 sin R2. Now here the refracted ray is grazing the surface. So what is R2 equal to 90 degrees critical angle? So this becomes N1 sin I equals N3, or sin I equals N3 by N1. So the answer is N3 divided by N1. Next one. Again, a question from optics. A boat has green light of wavelength lambda equals 500 nanometers on the mast. Mast andre head int artha. In simple to understand, there is a boat which is traveling with a green light of wavelength 500 nanometers. What wavelength would be measured? What will be the wavelength? And what color would be observed for this light? ನೀವು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕ್ಯುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಿರೋ ವೇವ್ ಲೆಂತ್ಗೆ ಯಾವ ಬಣ್ಣ ಯಾವ ಬೆಳಕು ಹೋಲುತ್ತೆ? ಆಸ್ ಸೀನ್ ಬೈ ಎ ಡೈವರ್ ಸಬ್ಮರ್ಜ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಬೈ ದ ಸೈಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಬೋಟ್. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಹಿಯರ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ವಾಟರ್, ದೇರ್ ಈಸ್ a boat which is traveling with green light, wavelength is given, and there is the rarer medium, green light in the air, rarer medium. Igenagutte, there is a diver submerged in water beside the boat. So there is a diver who is inside water. Now please to remember, water is the denser medium. So the diver is in the denser medium. You have to calculate what will be the wavelength of light and the particular color measured by this diver. Green color when it is seen in the rarer medium. What will be the color for what wavelength as seen in the denser medium? ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನೊಂದು ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ತಗೊಳ್ತೀವಂದ್ರೆ, ಆಸ್ ಲೈಟ್ ಟ್ರಾವೆಲ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ರೇರರ್ ಟು ಡೆನ್ಸರ್ ಮೀಡಿಯಂ, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ವೆಲಾಸಿಟಿ ಅಂಡ್ ವೇವ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸಸ್. ನೌ ವೇವ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಆಫ್ ಲೈಟ್ ಇನ್ ವಾಟರ್, ಈ ಡೈವರ್ಗೆ ಯಾವ ಕಲರ್ ಕಾಣಿಸುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ನೋಡ್ಕೋಬೇಕಲ್ವಾ, ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ವೇವ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಆಫ್ ಲೈಟ್ ಇನ್ ಏರ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ರಿಫ್ರಾಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಇಂಡೆಕ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ವಾಟರ್. ವಿಚ್ ವಾಸ್ ದ ವೇವ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಇನ್ ಏರ್ ರೇರರ್ ಮೀಡಿಯಂ? ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಲೈಟ್. ವಾಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ವೇವ್ ಲೆಂತ್? ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ 500 nanometers. Refractive index of water 4/3. When you simplify this, this is approximately 376 nanometer. And which color of light will possess this? naturally it has to be blue. The wavelength of blue is 376 nanometers. So the answer is blue of wavelength 376 nanometer. Now, again from optics, a prism based question, interesting. Two beams of red and violet colors are made to pass separately through a prism of angle 60 degrees. There are two colors. Which are that? Yaudara color? Red and violet. They are passing through a prism separately. First, red color na prism mel incident martivi, pass martivi. Next, violet na prism mulka pass martivi, where the angle of the prism is 60 degrees. In the minimum deviation position, what will be the angle of refraction inside the prism? Minimum deviation position. Position where the two lights, colors deviate minimum. Now, angle of the prism is given to be 60 degrees. At minimum deviation, what is the basic condition? Nodi concept galella nimge gottirbeku. Illi yavudunu higher order mathematical calculation illa. They are simple logic based calculations. So what is happening at the minimum deviation position? A becomes equal to 2R. Please to remember, at the minimum deviation position, angle of the prism is 2 times R, which means R is 30 degrees. So both the colors suffer a refraction of 30 degrees at the minimum deviation. Minimum deviationally, all colors suffer the same angle of refraction. So it is 30 degrees for both colors. Next question, students. This is an assignment for you again. I've already worked out this. Use our favorite lens maker's formula. So using the favorite lens maker's formula, 1 by F is N minus 1, 1 by R1 plus R2. Substitute, you will get the answer. Next one. The wavelength of light used in Young's double slit experiment is lambda. Yenen perform martidivi? Young's double slit experiment, where the wavelength of light used is lambda. Intensity at a point on the screen where the path difference is lambda by 6. Some point on the screen, a screen mele, yaudo one point alli, yelli path difference lambda by 6 ide, intensity is I. If I naught denotes the maximum intensity, then the ratio of I and I not has to be calculated. First, what is the relationship between I and I not? We say I equals I not cos square phi divided by 2, where phi is called the phase difference. Nenapanta, phase difference. But I don't know what is the phase difference, but I know the path difference is lambda by 6. So easily I will write phase difference is 2 pi by lambda times the path difference. Nenpitkoli, phase difference. How do you relate phase and path? Lambda by 2 pi by lambda, path difference. Or this is equal to 2 pi by lambda into lambda by 6. Here pi by 3, which is nothing but 60 degrees. So I have the phase as pi by 3, which is 60 degrees. So I by I naught equals cos square phi by 2, 30, root 3 by 2 whole square, 3 by 4, which is 0.75. So 0.75 is the correct answer. Next one. What is the minimum thickness? Minimum thickness keltidare, least thickness of a thin film required for constructive interference in the light reflected from it. I have to calculate the minimum thickness of a thin film for constructive interference. So condition bariyana. So for constructive interference, 2 mu t is 2 n plus 1 lambda by 2, where n is 0, 1, 2, etc. Now, if you observe minimum thickness, since he is asking minimum thickness, n becomes equal to 0. Minimum. So n is 0. So 2 mu t equals lambda by 2. Because n is 0. Why n has become 0? It is for minimum thickness. E condition important nimge, constructive interference. Or t is equal to lambda divided by 4 mu. So t is lambda divided by 4 mu. Substitute, you will arrive at the answer. Now, there is a uniform electric field of intensity E, which is as shown. Uniform electric field of intensity E. In uniform electric field andre, e field olage elle charge nitro, it will experience the same magnitude of force. Uniform electric field olage elle one charge idi, ಅದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗೋ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಸೇಮ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. How many labeled points have the same electric potential as the fully shaded point? How many of them will have the same electric potential? See, when you have studied equipotential surfaces, for a plane, the equipotential surface, very clearly for a plane, was at right angles to it. Very clearly we told right angles. This is the shaded part. So 1, 2, 3. So the answer has to be 3. Critical angle. Again, a very simple question. Sine inverse 0.6. Polarizing angle for that medium. Polarizing angle antakshna yen nent barut namge. Brewster's law. What did Brewster's law say? N is tan theta p. Alva. Simple. Brewster's law. Refractive index is tangent of the polarizing angle. Andre, theta p is tan inverse n. Nodi, tan inverse barbeko. Fourth option hoito. Now, I have n. Tan theta p from Brewster's law. Or theta p is tan inverse n. Now, critical angle is given. C is sine inverse 0.6. Or sine C is 0.6. Anywhere can I relate refractive index and critical angle? Very simple. It is 1 by sine C. Or N is 1 by 0.6. I've arrived at N. So this is nothing but tan inverse 1 by 0.6. So the answer has to be tan inverse 1 divided by 667. See, very simple. Know these relations. Know these concepts. Where am I landing at? Very easy. Next, nature of electromagnetic wave. An electromagnetic wave consists of electric and magnetic vectors which are mutually perpendicular planes vibrating with a phase of pi. So the phase difference between the electric vector and the magnetic vector is pi. So this is the answer. Circuit based. Already we have solved. Again we will do this. All capacitors used in this diagram. All the capacitors used in this circuit are identical, and each one has a capacitance C. Then what is the effective capacitance between A and B? First, I will rearrange these capacitors. I will draw a simple circuit that can be easily solved. So, these three neutral capacitors I consider. And again, these three neutral capacitors. And further, the combination is connected in series across E and B. So this is C, C and C. Come see, these three capacitors are connected in parallel. Capacitors in parallel, C1 plus C2 plus C3. So the effective capacitance 3C agutte. C, C and C again in parallel. Resistors alla, capacitors. This again becomes 3C. This 3C and 3C are in series. So CSS 3C into 3C divided by 3C plus 3C. 9C square divided by 6C. So this is 3 by 2C. So 1.5C will be the answer. Naturally, here after recombination, force on a system should be greater than the initial force. Always remember, if there is recombination of charges, redistribution of charges, the force in the later situation should be greater than the initial force. This is from the previous syllabus. Since we don't study anything with respect to grating here, I don't take this question for discussion. Next one. A battery of EMF E has an internal resistance small r. So there is a battery, EMF E, internal resistance is small r. A variable resistance capital R is connected across the terminals of the battery. So capital R is connected across the terminals of the battery. On the battery there, question prakara, EMF of the battery is E, internal resistance is R. There is an external variable resistance capital R connected in the circuit. I is the current that is drawn from the battery, and V is the terminal potential difference. If R alone is gradually decreased to zero, ee variable resistance na gradual agi, very slowly, if I am reducing to zero, then which of the options should describe the nature of current and potential? Cell has EMF E, internal resistance R. It is connected to an external resistance R. Then what happens to current? What is the expression for current? I is equal to E divided by R plus R. Idinim nenpirbeku. I cannot derive it here now. On the assumption that you know this concept, when there is EMF, when there is external resistance, internal resistance, current is given by E divided by R plus R. Now he says R reduces to zero, so I is equal to E by R.
What happens to the potential?
Ohm's law.
V is I into R. If R is tending to zero, V has to be zero. So the answer is I approaches E by R, whereas V approaches zero. So D is the option.
Three voltmeters are connected as shown in the diagram. Very clearly, if you analyze, this is VB and VC. They are connected in parallel, so they should read the same potential, which is the output of the two terminals. Always remember, output potential of the two terminals will be the same as the two voltmeters in parallel. So V1 is equal to V2 is equal to V3. Assignment question for you all. Kirchhoff's law. A will be the answer. When I say assignment question, see that you work out. When, even if you go wrong, no problem. But at least that sadiality, you start thinking and working out will be there. Now, follow very carefully. If this key is closed, the key behaves like a switch. If the key is closed, now this is closed, there will be some current which will be drawn by B2. But on the other hand, if the key is open, the circuit is open, conducting path will open, B2 will draw no current from the source. When the key is open, B2 is connected across the key. You'll open agogide, switch off adange, no conducting path. So B2 cannot draw current from the source. But there is some power consumption, which means power increases. It is not drawing current, but there is dissipation of power. Power across B2 increases. B1 is connected in series with B2, which means power decreases here. So in this situation, brightness of the bulb B2 has to increase and brightness of the bulb B1 has to decrease. So brightness of the bulb B1 decreases and that of B2 increases. Next one. A conceptual question. Magnetic field at the center of a circular coil of radius R, due to the current I flowing through it, is B. Simple aga understand maadkobekadre, magnetic field at the center of a circular coil is B. The magnetic field at a point along the axis at a distance R from the center. It's a conceptual one. Always remember, it is B divided by root 8. In comparison to the magnetic field at the center, magnetic field at a point on the axis is always B divided by root 8. This is again just quantitative. Q and R will be the answer. there is a uniform magnetic field. Uniform magnetic field directed perpendicular and into the plane. So magnetic field is acting into the plane and perpendicular. Irregular conducting loop is changing into a circular loop in the plane of the paper. There was an irregular loop which is becoming a circular loop. Then current is always induced in the loop and it happens in the anti-clockwise direction.